attention elsewhere. Right, you will drive the last part of this service from Stratford to Mark's Tey. We did part one earlier on. There are some short stops making sure of the traffic to pass or waiting for an empty slot for you to pass over the main line. Because your train is quite slow, you're routed via the slow line towards Shenfield. Maximum speed is 60. We got front lights. Excellent. Wiper, long approved wiping. Casbeck, thank you for the host. On the brake. So this version of the 66 had the custom height HUD, and it's just a different shape of lever. That's really all it boils down to. Remember, the 66 has slightly different braking style. Right. Double yellow, so we're clear through Stratford. Diamond, that's an awesome name. Thanks for the follow, much appreciated. ABJD, thank you for the host. So this scenario is by Cell 601. We did part one quite some time ago. And it was excellent from what I recall. So this is a longer second part. Gone green up ahead now. That's good. Excellent. Hey Alu 14, welcome. No, Mr. Train Cab, the TSL bot isn't running at the moment. We're going to do Twitch Place Train Sim next. We're now stopping at the Ilford Down Avoider in 2.6 miles. Meanwhile, we've got green lights. Right, now we get the 90. Yeah, so Twitch Plays Train Sim today is... you're starting at King's Cross with the Flying Scotsman. And it's a similar consist to the one that it used on the 14th of Feb. It was the 14th of Feb, whenever it did its last run out of King's Cross. And you will be driving to stop at three stations, one of which is Networth. in a steam engine with flight Scotsman itself. Ribku, you've had Ruby paints for the BR155 NAP file. Yes, it will remove them if you verify, because it does a check on all of the files and fixes them if they are wrong. So in this case, it would find that it's the same as if it's a corrupted file. Great Western Geek, what are we playing today? So we're driving the Class 66 on the GEML up to Mark's Tey, I think, is where we end. Yep. And after that, we're going to do Twitch Plays. Pulling aggregates. Double yellow, so this is for the red light at the down avoider. Hey Chris Rogers, welcome. So are you all ready to drive steam engine? It'll be on automatic fireman this time, we're not gonna mess about with that. Screw it up like last time. T, thanks for the host, much appreciated. Have we watched the railway getting Britain's railway back on track? I don't think so, no. Something I remember seeing. We'll stop at the Ilford Down Avoider marker. XL Hunter 3, thank you for the host. Is that a green screen of the train cabin? It's a green screen of a train cabin. I don't know which one I've actually got running at the moment. I'll fix that in a minute once we get onto this this stop. I'm just running up to a red light at the moment, so I feel like I should probably watch what I'm doing for a change.
uphill here, isn't it?
Yeah, I have been slacking off with regards to YouTube. I know I need to get my backside in gear. My name is Jeff. Can I ask you to stop spamming the chat, please? You've made the request. You don't need to make it once, 400 times. Right, what have we got for a background at the moment? It is indeed a Class 66. Look at that. States it is the right cab. You have to wait a couple of minutes for a passenger train to pass. When the signal clears, you'll drive your train over the slow lines towards Shenfield. Be aware of one of the signals around Romford. You will need to tap the signal in order to pass it. Why isn't there a different ADOS tone for a red light? That will make more sense, because then if a driver's about to spad, the alert that was red. You get an ADOS tone if you need to be paying attention. More than normal. The fact that it's a red is kind of, you know, it's even a yellow you should be approaching with caution. Hence why it's a caution, I suppose. But, yeah, you should still be approaching. And the only time you don't have to pay the same degree of attention is if it's green. Anything else, you should be paying attention. Red is not, okay, it's special because it's a spad, but yellows and reds, you should be treating all with the same care. Verbatim, what we're doing tonight, if you type exclamation mark show, you'll get that information. Starting off on the GEML. What's the proper way to change gears on trains? Rev throttle down, wait for the RPMs to come down, gear up, and then put your throttle back up again. Same as you would on a car or a bike or something. Some great AI in this, isn't it? Baldwin 7, I have a friend watching me and asked if I was in British. Yes, I am indeed British. I am about as British as they come. There we go, struggling up. Come on, you can do it. Double yellow, so we're clear. We get a yellow on the starter from Milford. Amtrak lover just applied for the JetBlue student gateway training program. What's that all about then, Amtrak lover? Oh, Oh, very nice Amtrak level. Well, good luck with that. And I try to get the mole man back on the stream. The mole man's busy. He will be here whenever he can be, and that was it. I was not meant to stop there, that was a gunfire. You're lying to me. Together. That's amazing. If I got a double amber at this next signal, I'd have a third of a mile to stop. Speed limited to 60 miles per hour. It seems to brake reasonably well, actually. When I stopped at the last waypoint, it was the brake seemed to be quite effective. Kevrev, there's no point whispering me because I'm using IRC, so I don't get. The whispers don't come up. If you want to send something privately, send it in a Twitch message and I can get it on there. Yeah, this is what I'm thinking. So a third of a mile seems I might need to put my feet out and wave my hands and flags and coat out the window as well. I'll be the one chucking everything out the window. Easy. That's the single yellow. 4 parts of Mark's Tey Empties, Kevrev. I only found 2 when I looked on Steam. Who made the GEML, Jeff? It was made by Dovetail. Why are you so limited to the controls you can pan to? You can pan to all the official controls, you just can't pan to the non-official controls. Dave, yes, I've done part one. Ages ago, though. How much longer on this one, Calspec? This is a 70-minute scenario, so we've probably got a fair bit. We're only at Gideon Park. We've got to get to Mark's Tey. Which is a fair way along the line. Not all the way. I think it's in the Colchester area or something like that. I can't remember if it's before or after Colchester. Yes, T, we're just looking for somewhere to park, mate. Well, it said, Kevrev, I looked on my scenario list and I've got a tick next to the scenario, so that would seem to me to be a good indicator. Oh, this is that one I've got a tab, I guess. Sitting here wasting time. L413, is that the one it said to tab? Let me look at the map, is there any reason why I'm stuck here? No, there isn't. Seven. Thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Good night, Darkness Monster, thanks for popping in, and welcome to Coppin' Up a Mow! For those that's just joining, Twitch Plays is after this. see you just said something about a loco in the fog, and then it flew straight up the screen. So apologies there. But yes, I think I know what you're saying, and it is excellent. Love that 24. Drop it to 2040. Comes to Guinea Park. See you later, Naughty Nutter. Oh, excellent, Chris. Am I up to date on your scenarios, Chris? Have I played them all, or am I missing any? I've got this horrible feeling I'm missing one. T, that was a 360 EMU. There's loads of them on this line. Dave, yes, class 73. I'm also going to do another one on the 87, because I was talking to someone earlier on who had a lot of problems doing the fault reset process. It's not straightforward, so I thought I would cover this, the intercity version, the 87, and how to do that. So yes, I should do both of those this week, I think. Jamie Clausord, welcome. Mr. Steelman, this is the GEML from Steam. Well, everything I've got comes from Steam. Including the scenario, which comes from Steam Workshop. That sounds really interesting, Chris. That'll make a nice change. Which route is that on? SFCRW, yes, there are two US scenarios after Twitch Plays. There, and then it'll only brake to that point. If you then want to release the brakes, you can put it back. And whenever you put the control in the middle, it will hold the brakes where they are. So, for example, I could put it down to here. I can then release it back to 4 and put it back up. Whoops. Ah, there you go. Okay, my accuracy is not very good, but you see the point. It's just use that, and when it's in the middle, it will hold that at the say at the right position. Yeah, and this is the current braking. This is where you want it to get to, and then that'll tell you, that should hopefully help you. If I did make Twitch drive this train, I'd just put a command where you'd set what you want the brake bar to the air brake bar to be automatically, same as I've done for the steam trains. Yes, I have got a Just Giving page set up for the 24-hour stream, Lost Chris. I will post details of it nearer the time. Alright, we've got approach. Is that ours? I guess that's ours. It's on the wrong side, but... Right, we're not stopping at Shenfield, we're going through. Neil, thank you for the host, much appreciated. With a route indicator, slow down to 25. Yeah, for those that aren't already aware, there is going to be another 24-hour stream on, I think it's the 9th and 10th of April, which is a Saturday and Sunday. It'll be in aid of cancer research. RMS Titanic 1912, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Obviously going downhill. Your next stop is Witham for a short wait. Your maximum speed is 60 miles per hour. But after the 25, presumably. BNSF, apologies, thank you for the host. Chris, how will I prep for the stream? Portaloo, lots of green tea and chalky bars. Lots of green pea, green tea, Freudian slip there. and the Nutri-Grain type bars. We've got an 80 limit now. I shall just have to do frequent toilet breaks as I did last time. Remember people at one point, towards the end of the stream, were saying, my word, is he just living in the toilet now? Game volume's a little high. What does everybody else say? Because everybody else... This is what it was set at previously, and everyone said it was fine. SFCRW, thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. Leave everything where it is. You want to hear this one, Loco. This is beautiful, Loco. It's got lovely sounds. You don't want to hear me. Game volume fine. Mick needs muting. Yeah, thanks. Well, that's an interesting one. An Anglia 90 on freight. Belge 18. Thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. Vectron DE, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Kevrev, will I be accepting workshop scenario requests for the 24-hour stream? Absolutely, I should be going through the backlog. We made, I think, 26, 27 scenarios during the last 24-hour stream, so I'm banking on getting through probably a similar number of scenarios. Just realise I'm about to speed. BNSF, you can only pan to the controls that are documented in the dev in the folder, in the documentation. You can't make it pan to anything else. In the 24-hour stream, I am going to be having a PZB challenge segment. So don't forget that, folks. Main down and Ingatestone. I used to live in Ingatestone. ...24-hour shunting scenario. What, you're another one of darknesses, you mean? You get to the 23rd hour and then it will fail to couple or something. No. Am I going to use the Steam controller? I don't know, to be honest. Dark shunting scenarios are evil, I hear they're now banned under the Geneva Convention, absolutely. Joe the Fish's 7-hour maglifs. Hello in Gatestone! Any FSX in the 24-hour stream? Yes, I'm going to do a bit more of that than I did in the last 24-hour stream. I am desperately trying to get Fly Time Live started. I'm going to try and do it this week. We need to do TPTS pump car tomorrow. Let me make a note of that. TPTS pump car has to happen tomorrow. We keep talking about it, I keep forgetting about it. I hope the train's alright. I'm not paying any attention to it. I've got a spreadsheet open over the top of the window. Right, I've updated the... I don't use the steam controller much. That's because I've got a rail driver. Like the steam controller is good, but because I've got the rail driver, I think the rail driver is better for driving the trains. See you later, T. Thanks for stopping by. Apple. I've no idea at the moment. I haven't seen that one. Which one is that one? I certainly got nothing wrong with the Steam controller, and I use the Steam controller at work sometimes. TPTS Chengdu signing. He doesn't know if I spent it. Hey Steve, what? Where did that go? Miles to Whittam down loop. Will I be using the Steam controller on the next 24-hour stream? I don't know, to be honest. You tell me what you want me to do. I certainly can do it. It's sitting in the bag in the other room. I carry it to work and back so that I've got it wherever I want it. Cheers, X-Shooter. Have fun with your Scrum project, eh? TPTS 24-hour stream. Yeah, that would be entertaining, wouldn't it? CompuFreak, did I ever play in 4K? Do you mean, do I ever play Train Sim in 4K? I haven't got a 4K screen. None of my screens now are 4K, so no. I know someone at work who says he played it in 4K and it looks spectacular. That'll be for the 90 to 60 speed drop. Stopper, Portsmouth Direct Line. Well, that sounds interesting, Apple. Let me take a look, put that on the list to look at. Alright, I've put it on the list for Friday, potentially. Alan, would I have done the same plan like the next for the next 21, like some Minecraft, FSX fishing and training? Probably yes. I think the variety worked well. The Minecraft stream lets me go and have some lunch while the minecraft does take over. Got some lunch, some dinner. Colchester, this looks like. CowSpec 3, why does UKTS take so long to download things and why is there a download queue? Oh, don't get me started. Servers cost money. Bandwidth costs money. There you go, Amarillo just said exactly the same. Sure, that's not Chelms. Yeah, it is Chelms for Mr. Steelman. I'm talking a load of old rubbish. Minecraft for Microsoft with a HoloLens. Oh, I'm looking forward to HoloLens. HoloLens should be very cool, especially Minecraft. Minecraft is going to be the first thing I do if I ever get to play with the HoloLens. Nothing sensible, just Minecraft. I played Minecraft with the Oculus Rift, it was epic. Hope HoloLens isn't ending up like Google Glass. I seriously doubt it. Not given how far they are through production already. Can you do the DTM stream with the Oculus Rift? It doesn't work with Oculus Rift anymore. This was a plugin for Minecraft, and it only worked with older versions of the Oculus Rift software. It's never been updated. Yeah, Google Glass was just bizarre. Absolutely bizarre. That's fine for walking around your own private campus, but it's just an absolutely bizarre thing to have outside in the real world. I've been thinking about Rift streaming. And I kind of want a view that I can't necessarily see much point. But I'm interested to hear what you all think. So for example, FSX. I could do an FSX stream with the Oculus Rift. And I could bring all the chat into the 3D world, so I could still interact with the chat and so forth, because it is that clever. So, what is... But you wouldn't obviously see it in 3D. You would just see the output of the Oculus Rift. So I'm not sure there's much benefit. It would all be for me rather than for you. So can't really bring chat into the 3D. I know it works really, really well actually. They can bring all sorts of things, even like flight planning tools, you can bring them into the 3D world. It's done really cleverly. go, K-Dog. Sixty is the max limit on this train, Morgan, yes. When did I get into all this train level stuff? All my life! It was my dad. It's all his fault. APT Steve tasted Hershey's and doesn't want to repeat that again. Amen. Amen. The only exception to that is they've got like a cookies and cream bar, and that's epic. But otherwise than that, like Hershey Kisses, get that kiss away from me. Environment sounds, they take a lot of RAM. I think anything like that has to be loaded. So, the bigger the sounds, obviously, the more the memory. So, I'd be sensible with your sounds. My favourite chocolate is dark chocolate. Dark chocolate is awesome. Right, we're going downhill now, so we have to watch the speed. Right. Right, we've got another. We're stopping a whip and down loop actually. Speed down. We're way behind anyway, so I'm fast. Do I think the train sim runs smoother on Windows 10 than 8.1? I don't know, to be honest. It certainly doesn't run any worse than on Windows 8.1. I don't know whether it runs smoother. Probably very much a your mileage may vary type thing. Is there a wiper issue? No, I think there's a switch over here for the other wiper. And it drives everybody nuts because they're not in sync. So I don't operate the other one. Right, and we're coming into this siding and being held. We've got a red light in front of us. Drop it to 15, given we're approaching a red. Ah, someone sends me a Skype message just as I'm approaching a red. Genius. Dave, dear oh dear. You even know I'm driving up to a red light. Amarillin, you're just as bad. Is that block button? Are we in yet? We're nearly in. Right, we're in the siding. Stop now. Does anyone here remember that there used to be an extra crunchy peanut butter? I think it was a Sunpat one. And it was basically whole roasted peanuts in peanut butter. It was awesome, and they stopped making it. I was gutted. They just have this crunchy peanut butter, which almost feels tastes like there's nothing in there now compared to that. Right, this is a book stop, making sure that there is an empty slot at Mark's Tey to cross over the main line. Oh, hello. At Mark's Tey, you will drop your consist, drive around your train and stable your engine at one of the headshots. It's a bit late for the ideal screenshot, but I'm going to take a screenshot here anyway. Yellow. Good evening, Deadly Dorito. Double yellow. Miles to MKT. Steve, you are... Yes, please do. Send me one of your scenarios. Following a train in front, but given we're currently doing 25 and it's doing 100 miles an hour, there you go, it's green. Did it do it? No, I haven't watched any TV today at all. I get home, have dinner, and then spend the rest of the evening planning the stream and doing the stream. It takes up so much time, it's unbelievable. It's good fun though, or I wouldn't do it. Right. 7.5 miles to Mark's Tey Tarmac siding 2. Doesn't your missus get stroppy all the time you spend planning and streaming? Sometimes. Sometimes I do have to sort of, sometimes why I don't do a stream, because I've sort of read the room, if you like. No, 99 times out of 100, she is very, very supportive. Sometimes she recognises that I might be pushing it a bit too far. Get Hank out of pocket. What the hell? Oh dear. Here we go. Sneezy sneeze. Chris, yeah, if you drop me an email, uktrainsim@googlemail.com. Oh, dear. Yeah, I haven't forgotten Penn Central. I haven't forgotten. Don't get ill again. I better not. I'm getting bored again now. I just get sneezes every now and again. I won't worry about it. Yeah, anyway. TPTS today have a reference in Orbital Run. It kind of does, but I've sort of twisted it a little bit. Because it only goes as far as Hitchin. And you've got some stops to make. Because... But it's the same concept, starting at the same platform, following essentially the same route. Till Films won't be any third-party routes anytime soon. Well, if the route is on is available on Steam, which does include, there's Just Trains routes available on Steam. There's Aerosoft routes on Steam. I run all of those. If it's on Steam, I run it. If it's not on Steam, I don't. It's okay, Steve. The chances of anything coming from Mars are 1,000,000 to 1. So they said. Nice apple. I got the War of the Worlds theatrical show on DVD. I'm sure it's nowhere near as good as going there, but I really enjoyed it. Really like Jeff Wayne's work. You will never see Twitch stops at Nebworth. Fringe Starling, I don't think any of us are going to see Twitch stops at Nebworth. I really like the Tom Cruise film. I don't know whether that's a controversial thing to say, but I really liked it. Because it was a lot closer to the original book, except for the visuals being a bit sort of not close and being in America. Actually, it wasn't close at all to the book. What am I waffling about? It wasn't even remotely close to the book. It wasn't. No, it wasn't. But I really enjoyed it. So, good enough. It's just like the book, except where it isn't, and it's in the wrong country. And it's set in modern day, and... I'd heard they were making an animated series, or an animated movie, based on the Jeff Wayne vision for War of the Worlds. And I think it got held up. It was looking stunning. It was looking absolutely incredible. Which class is 66? I don't actually know which class this is. This one is. It's obviously a 66, but I don't know which version it is. The fact that it's got the diamond on the drain break tells me it's one of the earlier ones. And I'm going to go with 66 V2, possibly. Right, this is Mark's Tey. Day of the Triffids is really good. Did you see the remake version of it? I thought that was excellent as well. Metallica, you didn't like War of the Worlds with Tom Cruise? Oh, I liked it. It was great. Stopped with enough to reverse back into a sighting behind me. Let's just have a look. We are then going to come back to so we drop where we are here, we go forward to sighting 2 shot, we then come back via sighting shot, which I guess puts us back in there. I see. Alright, so we need to uncouple now. Another 360 blasting past us there. Drive around your trainer, stable your engine at Mark's Tey tarmac sighting shot. start accelerating and totally forgetting that I was going to be stopping in a minute. Jeez, what's going on? VNSF, you finally hit 2,000 hours. Good man. Finished. Hey, we've even cleared the junction. Let me change that. All of a sudden there's a plethora of AOA going past us. Another 360. Please set the switches manually and drive towards Mark's Tey tarmac siding. Shunt. Well, yeah, indeed, BNSF. I presume you took a screenshot. How many scenarios will I play on a 24-hour stream, Mr. Traincar? Well, last time we successfully completed 23 scenarios. We actually attempted, I think, 25 or 26, but we had two or three crashes. Hey there, Howie. Welcome. Mr. Steelman, when is the 24-hour stream? April 9th and 10th. Good evening, Gauja. Got white lights into the siding. You drove for the first time and soldier summit yesterday and got sick of doing 14-hour horns. That's awesome. Coming up to a buffer stop and someone's Skyping me. It's an instant guaranteed message. Right. Yeah, I'm watching you, Emma. Right, end of the scenario. Boom. I thoroughly enjoyed that. So, that was Mark's Tey Empties Part 2, Cell 601 on the Great Eastern Main Line. Superb. We enjoyed. I enjoyed that. I did run the other part of it at some point quite a bit previously, so if you dig it up, then you should be able to find it if you're interested. It was only a 35-minute scenario, the first part. Okay, right. Let me switch it to changing routes, because I need to get this ready, because it's your turn.